LA Weekly. Hey,
everybody,
it's that
Paul Spawn fan. I'm here for sure.
Okay, I get it.
Makes sense now.
Yeah, but as soon as it's happening, you're like, I can see the casting.
How are you tonight?
I'm fantastic. Yeah, thank you very much.
Good. Now, how'd you get hooked up with Oxfam?
Well, Sean gave me a call and said, would you come down and help support us?
Absolutely.
And, you know, I'm a part of a group that's called Our First 100 Days, making his first 100 days our first 100 days, and taking it back and doing good charitable work. So anytime I have a chance to do something, to put some positivity and to support, you know, I'm not about it right now.
So how can people find that group that you just mentioned?
Oxfam?
Yeah, the 100 Days.
Oh, First 100 Days.
First 100 Days.
I believe it's a Facebook group that I'm involved in. Like, I got COVID, so that's not something. But, you know, I encourage everybody, you know, whether it's a dollar a day, you know, or like $10 a month to Planned Parenthood or ACLU. I mean, we are the government, so we need to do what we can. They work for us. You know that moment?
Yes,
like, that senator works for me. This hospital, and it's working. So keep putting positivity out there, guys. Keep doing it.
Yes, absolutely. So I heard a little story once about, from Victoria actually, that one time when you guys were filming the car scene, Once Upon a Time.
Oh, that she's a horrible driver and she almost killed me? She's a drunk, mad woman, like crazy Irish bitch. So I love her with all of my heart. But she's, I mean, a maniac. She's an absolute maniac. At first she wouldn't do it. She made them do, like, you know, pull things around. And then all of a sudden it was like, oh, she got comfortable. And then I almost died. And then, like, it's snowing and it's Vancouver. And
that's
thanks.
So not even the story, but I love
thanks.
That one.
Oh, what's the story?
Well, that you were filming in between takes. I guess you had been, like, flying back and forth for a few things and filming that you fell asleep.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Like, if you watch the episode when we are in the car, like, with the train and all, like, and Lana's with us, and we were shooting, and I had been in London for the holidays, and it was Friday night, and it was 3 o'clock in the morning, and I was literally pinching my legs, like pinching my legs to stay awake. And you can actually see my leg. Like, I fell asleep. Like, they would go line, and then Kristen would say her line, and I was like, I'm out.
So, okay, so we're here, and I'm not watching the Big Little Lies finale.
I know. What are we all doing? Like, this is great. I hope everybody's taping it. It's crazy. Like, what am I doing here? I mean, like, I'm here for a cause, but oh my god, right?
How is filming that?
No, I'm going to do something. Tomorrow morning is
glorious. Really glorious. Amazing. They're just generous, lovely, amazing people. Sean Mark, probably, is fantastic. I'm so lucky to be a little tiny piece of that magic. So.
I loved you in it. I was like, oh, there she is. And I'm just like,
I think you get a little more Dungey tonight. I think you get a little like slice of Detective Quinlan because she's up to some shit.
Like, do I ask her for a spoiler?
No.
It's technically on HBO Go.
No. I know nothing.
I know. I like to be surprised.
I know I'm in it. Looking
yes,
at stuff.
I assume
talking
I assume
to people.
So.
I can tell you that. Spoiler alert. I'm in there.
So we're done, coat. Though. It's done. The show is...
I don't know.
Okay.
Mini trench coats, red, sweet, furry, or something. Very delicious.
Thank you so much.
Thank
are you
yeah.
performing? You're not performing.
No, God, no. I'm performing right now.
Yes.
But yeah, no.
You're the face of the operation.
Yes. You're the face and the bod of the operation.
Yes.
I'm drawing. I don't know. Thank you.